The sociological imagination consists of being able to look beyond your everyday life and the choices that you make as a direct cause for successes and failures. It really challenges you to step back and see the entire society that you live in for the cause of these things, potentially. In 1959, C. Wright Mills described this theory as enabling its predecessor to understand the larger historical scene in terms of its meaning for the inner life and the external career of a variety of individuals. Mill also goes on to describe people as knowing as being ordinary people who do not usually know what this connection means for the kind of people they're becoming and for the kinds of history making in which they might take part. They do not possess the quality of mind essential to grasp the interplay of individuals in society, of biography and history, of self and world. Being able to have sociological imagination is extremely critical for people as individuals and societies to understand on a large scale at that. It is important that people are able to relate the situations that they occur in their daily lives to local, national, and global societal issues that affect them every day, whether they see it or not. Without the ability to make these relations between the two, people are unable to see societal issues that affect them and can't really determine whether or not these issues require for them to improve their everyday lives and the situations that they may fall into. Throughout history, many different societies and nations have experienced and obtained different levels of sociological imagination. Some societies have never ever had it and have never obtained it and lost it, and some societies have gained it. The societies that have not obtained it or that have lost it are usually within nations that have suffered ongoing persecution, poverty, and social injustices. The societies that have obtained it and thrived on it are usually within the nations that had the most freedoms and have the most advanced cultures. The societies that have lacked sociological imagination have experienced authoritative government where they create the rules and establish the social and cultural norms. Individuals live within the same centuries, Individuals live within the same situations for centuries. I mean, thousands of years. These societies have lagged way behind what we call modern cultures, basically what we're used to today. Industrialization, freedom, and equality are all things that people in these societies lack. Or they're literally just beginning to attain them. We can all agree that this is a bit too late. Although we still struggle with the same things in America, for example, one of Mexican societies go through this all the time. The list goes from Mayan to the Aztec rulers to the Spanish rulers, and it can also be relative to the correct government that we have in America today. The people of Mexico have lived under autocratic rulers as poor working slaves. The only attempt that they were able to make in regards to social imagination was through a small revolution that they had to try to gain independence from their foreign rulers. The end result was that the local government still treated the same people the same way. Over time, this has become a common theme among many nations where social imagination has not been recognized. Individuals are trying to find their root of the problems, and they usually come to their senses about a lack of change in government or something like that that they live through every day, eventually. In nations where sociological imagination is prevalent, such as Japan and in the United States of America, social imagination has inspired historic changes to the cultures and the way of life. Thank you. Have a great day.